Hello friends, so today we are going to discuss about automotive differential. So in this video I am going to explain about how differential is working, what is the fundamental principle behind the working principle of differential, how tractor differential is different than the automotive differential, truck differential and car differential. And what are the different types of differential? What are the advantages and disadvantages of differential? And then we will solve some of the numerical problems, some conceptual problem and some numerical problems of gate. Okay. So moving ahead. So in this figure, as you can see, there are multiple figures are there. So number one is, I hope that you are able to see my cursor. So the first one is the truck differential. This is also a truck differential. This photograph, you can see the inside view of differential without housing. When you remove the housing, the differential will look like this. Okay, then tractor differential and then car differential, which we will also discuss. Okay, so basically what is the difference between a truck differential or a car differential or a tractor differential? So the main difference is the size of differential. If you can see the size of this truck differential, it's huge. Okay, similarly if you see a tractor differential, it is not visible, it will be inside, that will also be huge. But if you see a car differential, okay, if you might have seen a differential of a car, so if you see a car differential, then you will find out that the size is very small as compared to a truck differential or a tractor differential. Why it is so is because in case of tractor or a truck, the requirement of torque is very high. Okay, the truck has to carry a huge amount of load, pull implements which required huge amount of torque. So because gears will mainly fail because due to torque, so if the torque requirement in case of truck and tractor is very high, due to the high torque requirement, size of gears are huge in case of truck and in case of tractor. But if you see the example of car, in case of car, the main function is to provide you a speed, not torque. Torque requirement is there, but it's not very huge. So because of that, the size of a car differential is very less as compared to a truck as well as a tractor differential. Okay, now there are two figures here which you can see. Then this one is a rear wheel drive, this one is front wheel drive. So what is the difference? So in case of rear wheel drive, engine will produce power. That power will be transmitted to transmission. Okay, and then from transmission, power goes to differential with the help of this drive shaft. Now if it is a rear wheel drive car or rear wheel drive tractor, then it means that rear axle is the powered axle. Okay, so power from engine and transmission is going to the rear axle, so only one differential will be there, which will be attached with rear axle. Okay, and front axle or front tires are just used for steering purpose. It is not powered, it is just pushing. Okay, in case of front wheel drive, power from engine and transmission will go to front differential, so there won't be any rear differential. Okay, so this is a different difference between rear wheel drive and front wheel drive differential. In case of a tractor, you will not find any front wheel drive tractor. Okay, in case of almost all the tractor, drive will go to only rear axle. Okay, and front will be used for a steering purpose. Apart from these two, front wheel drive and rear wheel drive, there is third type, which is all wheel drive. In case of all wheel drive, as you can see, in case of front wheel, the differential is in the front. In case of rear wheel drive, differential is in the rear. If you have all wheel drive car, in that case, two differential will be there. One will be in the rear and one will be attached in the front. Okay, we will see how all wheel drive differential is working. In case of tractor, there are two types. One is rear wheel drive, okay, which is the most common tractor. Then second one will be your mechanical front wheel assist. In that case, there will be one differential in rear and one differential in the front, and there will be one switch. Whenever you are going, normally it will go in two wheel drive mode, but whenever you have less traction, you can apply that switch or that lever and your tractor will be converted into four wheel drive. Okay, so in that case, two differential will be there, one in the rear and one in the front. We will see that in my next slides. So this is in simple, in general terms, the normal introduction of differential. Okay, moving ahead. So this is me, you already know about me. Now, what are the functions of differential? We have seen how differential, how many types of differential are there in case of car or in case of tractor. So as I have told you that the only difference between a car differential, an automotive differential and a tractor differential is just the size of differential. Okay, in case of car, the size of differential will be less. In case of tractor or a truck, the size of differential will be very huge. Okay, apart from these two, this one difference, the function and the mechanism and everything of a car differential and tractor differential or a truck differential is 100% same. There is no any difference between a car differential or a tractor differential. Okay, so moving ahead, differential basically doing three types of things in a vehicle. When I'm saying vehicle, it means both car and truck as well as a tractor. Okay, so normally in all cases you will have an engine which is producing power. Then from engine there will be one clutch which will attach or detach your complete transmission system from engine. Then from clutch, power goes to transmission section. From transmission, power will go to differential. Okay, I think the first question comes in mind is why differential is required. Okay, so in case of a car or a tractor, your rear view, suppose we are talking about a two-wheel drive tractor or two-wheel drive car or a rear-wheel drive car, in that case your rear axle will be a powered axle. Okay, so you might have seen bullock cart. In case of bullock cart, you will have tires which are attached with axle, but there won't be any differential. Why? But why differential is required in case of a tractor or in case of a car? Is because in case of a bullock cart, you will have tires which is attached with your rear axle, and these tires are free to rotate on the rear axle. Okay, and your bullock cart axle is not powered axle. You will have bull instead of an engine, and your bull is just pulling your vehicle in forward direction. Okay, so when your bull is simply pulling your vehicle, in that case your axles are not powered axle. So at that time, you know, at the time why differential is required is because at the time of turning, your vehicle is suppose your vehicle, you consider it as a single body. So suppose if you are taking a left turn at that time, because it is acting as a single body, so at the time of turning, this inner wheel requires to travel a lesser distance, and at the same time your outer wheel is needed to travel a larger distance. Okay, so that the complete vehicle will make a complete turn. Okay, so now if both wheels are required to travel different distance in same amount of time, so to do that, your speed or the RPM of this outer wheel should be higher than this inner wheel, then only the vehicle will be able to achieve that. So in case of bullock cart, because your axle is not powered, so what is happening in that case, the resistance which is encountered by this inner wheel and outer wheel will be different. Okay, and because these two wheels are free to rotate on these axles, so your inner wheel will rotate at lower speed and it encounters higher resistance, and at the same time there will be lower resistance on outer wheel, and due to that your outer wheel will be able to travel faster. Okay, but now in case of your tractor or in case of your car, this is a powered wheel. Okay, so suppose if there is no differential, so even if your wheels are encountering different resistance, this complete rigid axle will not allow it to travel at different speeds. So then to overcome that difficulty, you need a differential. Okay, so basically this differential will help your tires to achieve different speeds. So this is the main function of differential. So the first function, as I told you, differential will do three basic functions in a vehicle. So the first one is to transmit engine power to wheel. So because your engine is producing x amount of torque, now that torque will come to transmission. Now in transmission you will have gearbox. In that gearbox you will multiply your speeds, okay, or you divide by your torque, whatever as per the requirement. In case of car, you just multiply your speed. In case of tractor, you multiply your torque. Okay, so now when it goes to differential, now I'm talking particularly about tractor. In case of tractor, you will achieve one more reduction in differential. How, that we will see later. So the first thing which differential is doing is to transmit engine power to wheel, or to multiply the torque. Okay, so first is to transmit engine power. Power will come from engine to transmission, then to differential, and then to two wheels. Then second is to act as a gear reduction in the vehicle. You will take one reduction in differential. So you reduce your speed and you are multiplying your torque. Okay. And the third function, which I have already told you, is your differential will allow your wheels to rotate at different speeds. And this is the name, this is the function which due to which differential is called as differential, because it allows your wheel to achieve different speeds. Okay, so basically your outer wheel will move at faster speed as compared to your inner wheel, and that is why we called it differential. So these are the three function which differential is doing in a vehicle, whether it is a car or a tractor. Okay, now moving ahead, so what is the basic principle behind differential? Okay, for that I will explain you with a diagram. So this is a self-explanatory diagram where each and everything is already written. So just try to see my cursor, where I'm moving my cursor. So this is the input shaft, which is coming from the gearbox, input to the differential and output to the gearbox. So from gearbox, after some whatever reduction you are taking, after that, this shaft is coming here, and this, at the end of this shaft, there is one bevel gear pair. Now, why you need a bevel gear pair? Because as you might have studied in your BTEC, that gears will be of different types: spur gear, helical gear, and bevel gear. So whenever you require a reduction, or you need different speeds, you need a gearbox. Okay, so you can achieve different speeds or different torque with the help of spur gear or a helical gear. Okay, but whenever you required 90 degree transmission, okay, the power is coming from this, and output is required here and here. So basically you are achieving a 90 degree transmission from here to here. So in this case, this you cannot do with the help of a spur gear or helical gear. For this, you need a bevel gear. Okay, so that is why we are using a bevel gear in case of differential. So this is the input bevel pinion. We call it bevel pinion, and we call second bigger gear, we call it crown wheel or crown gear or bigger bevel gear, whatever you want to name it. And normally this will be of a spiral bevel gear pair. I hope that you know what is a spiral bevel gear, what is a straight bevel gear. If you don't know, then just read a little bit about gears. Okay, so the first thing is input is coming from this side. So this is the first bevel pinion. This bevel pinion is in mess with this bigger bevel gear or crown wheel or crown gear. Okay, so power is coming from here, then it will go to here, this bigger gear. Now what is happening, this bigger gear is attached with this housing. Okay, this we call it differential housing. Now in actual case, in case of car and tractor, everything, this gear will be bolted with this differential housing. Okay, so whatever power is coming to this bigger crown gear, same power will go to this differential housing. So with same torque and same RPM, this differential housing will also rotate. Okay, so power basically coming from here through this bevel pinion, it will go to this crown gear. From this crown gear, power will go to this differential housing. Okay, now inside differential housing, there will be these holes. In these holes, this is a small gear, which is also a bevel gear. So normally in some cases there will be two bevel pinions. In this figure you can see this green colors, this one and this one. These are two bevel pinions or smaller pinions, and these two are two bigger bevel gears. Okay, so this is what is happening inside the differential unit, differential housing. So in this case there are two pinions, and these two pinions are attached with this differential housing. And then there will be two side bevel gears. This is actually your output. From here, your output shaft is attached with these two side bevel gears. So these two gears, we call it side bevel gear. These two gear, we call it differential pinion gear. These two, we call it crown wheel pinion gear. Okay. So now what is happening? Power is coming through this from this power goes to this. So suppose if this bevel pinion is rotating in clockwise direction, then this bigger gear will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. Now if bigger gear is rotating in anti-clockwise direction, because it is bolted with this differential housing, it will also rotate in anti-clockwise direction. Now what is happening is, in normal case, when your vehicle is going in a straight direction and you are not taking any turn, in that case what is happening, these two pinions are just revolving about this axis with this differential housing. As you can see, this pinion shaft is coming in the hole of this housing, so it will simply revolve with this differential housing, because this crown gear is rotating about this axis and crown gear is bolted with this housing, so this housing is also rotating about this axis, and because this pinion is attached with this housing, so pinion is also revolving about this axis. So when you are going straight, at that time this pinion are just revolving, but this pinion are not rotating about this central axis, not rotating on its axis, it is just revolving around, okay, about this axis. And because this pinion is in mesh with this side bevel gear, so these teeth will simply push this side bevel gear to rotate along with it. So this side bevel gear, these two will rotate about this axis. Okay, we will again see this, how this is happening. So I think that these all, whatever terms are written over here, is clear to you now. Now this output is going to attached with wheel, right wheel and left wheel in both the side. So what is happening is, whenever your vehicle is going straight, at that time whatever power is coming through from engine to this differential unit will be divided into two equal parts. One will go to right side, one will go to left side. Okay, now in case of a tractor, after differential you will have a final reduction unit. That final reduction unit might be a bull gear pair, which normally will be a spur gear, or it might be a planetary gear. Nowadays, whatever new tractors are coming, high power tractors, more than 50 HP tractors, those all have final drive. Final drive gear will be planetary gear. In all Mahindra tractor, you will find planetary gear reduction over there. So this output shaft will act as input for that planetary unit or final drive unit, and from there rear axle will come and rear tire will come. Okay, so half will come this side and half will go this side. So I hope the mechanism is clear to you now. So what is happening first? Torque is transferred from the engine via transmission gearbox to drive shaft. So this is your drive shaft. Now from drive shaft, a spiral bevel pinion gear takes its drive from the gearbox. So this is a spiral bevel pinion which is taking drive, and from this spiral bevel pinion, it meets with large spiral bevel ring, which is known as crown wheel, this ring which I have already explained to you. Now this crown wheel is attached with this differential housing. We also call it differential carrier. Okay, so it is also it is rotating with this bigger crown gear. Now this differential housing will accommodate two pinion or four pinion depending on the requirement, which I will explain to you after some time, and then two large bevel gears. Okay, and then differential pins will be there, which I will also explain to you after some time. Okay. Now this side bevel gear, if your final reduction is planetary, then this side bevel gear will be connected to sun shaft, which will be further connected to rear axle shaft. So what is happening is, when your vehicle runs on a straight road, each gears will rotate at same speed. Both this side bevel gear will rotate at the same speed. Okay, so same amount of RPM will go in both RH and LH. But whenever your vehicle negotiates a curve or a turn, then this pinion gear, these two pinion gears, will also start to rotate about this axis. Okay, on its own axis. Okay, and due to that rotation, your speed of these two side bevel gears will be different. And that's what I have written over here. But when vehicle negotiate a curve, this pinion gear will start rotating on side bevel gears, and hence both side bevel gear rotate at different speeds, and that is what we call differential action. Okay, now moving ahead, what is happening in case of two wheel drive tractor? There will be only one differential which will be attached in the rear end. But if you have a four wheel drive tractor, then there will be two differential unit. One will be attached at the rear and other will be attached at the front, driving the front tires. Now there is one more thing. As I've told you, all wheel drive, as you can see in this figure, there is one differential in the rear, one differential in the front, and there is also a central differential. Now why this central differential is required over here? Now, as I have told you, that differential is required to accommodate the different speeds of left wheel and right wheel. Okay. Now, suppose you have a all-wheel drive tractor, then your power is coming to both rear axle and both front axle. Okay. Now, what is happening in case of rear differential will accommodate the speed difference of this wheel and this wheel, this LHRH wheel. Similarly, your front differential will accommodate the speed difference or RPM difference of this front LH and RH wheels. But at the same time, even if your tire size is same, all four tire size is same, you will have a different resistance due to either manufacturing dissimilarity, dissimilarity, or and ground surface dissimilarity. Your all wheels, even if sizes are same, your all four wheels will encounter different amount of ground resistance. And because of that, even all four wheels have different speed. There will be little bit speed difference between all four wheels. So what is happening? This differential will accommodate this LH and RH difference. This differential will accommodate this LH and RH tire difference. But at the same time, if you combine this front axle and if you combine this rear axle, the speed, there will be some speed difference between this rear axle and front axle. Then who will accommodate that difference, that speed difference? So that will be done by this central differential. So in case of a complete all-wheel drive car, I'm saying car, if you see Mercedes car, BMW car, in that case there will be three differential if it is an all-wheel drive car. Okay, one in the rear, one in the front, and one will be in the center. So the central differential will accommodate the speed difference between this rear axle, both rear tires, and both front tire. But in case of tractor, even if it is an all-wheel drive tractor, you will not find any central differential. Why is it so? Is because in case of tractor, your maximum speed is 40 kmph, and whenever you are operating at in four-wheel drive mode, you are you normally run at maximum 20-25 kmph. So because your speed is very less, so in that case the speed difference between front and rear will be very less, so that can be accommodated even without differential. Okay, so that is why in case of all-wheel drive tractor, we are not putting any central differential. If you see Mahindra Thar, I hope that you all are aware about Thar vehicle, which is a Jeep, Mahindra Jeep basically you can say, and four-wheel drive Bolero also. In that case also, you will not find any central differential. Okay, now the natural question will come in your mind that it is a car, it can run at a very high speed, then why central differential is not there? So in that case, they will give warning on the vehicle that your vehicle should not operate beyond a certain speed in four-wheel drive mode. So you have to follow that instruction. If that instruction is not there, then they will have to give this central differential. Okay, so if your speed is less, then you don't need a central differential, but if your speed is high, then you will need a central differential if your vehicle is complete all-wheel drive. So I have spoken about three terms: one rear wheel drive, one front wheel drive, one mechanical front wheel assist, and the final one all-wheel drive. So what is the difference? Rear wheel drive, you know, there will be only one difference. Your rear wheel is powered and one differential will be in the rear. That will be your rear wheel drive. If it is a front wheel drive, then there will be one differential in the front and your front axle is powered. If it is a mechanical front wheel assist, in that case what is happening, you will have a differential in rear, you will have a differential in the front, and you normally power will go to rear axle, but whenever you require more traction at that in that case, you can simply switch to four wheel drive mode. So it is an on-off condition, on-off situation, where you can simply on the four-wheel drive mode. In that case, your vehicle will all four-wheel drive will be powered. And whenever you are not switching to four-wheel mode, your vehicle will simply operate as a rear-wheel drive. Okay, so that is we called mechanical front-wheel assist if it is on-off condition. But if you are talking all-wheel drive, in this case, what is happening is power will always go to all four wheels. So both front and rear will be powered all the time. There won't be any switch to put it on or off, or to put it in two wheel drive or four wheel drive mode. So if you are saying all wheel drive, it means that it is always all wheel drive. If you are saying mechanical front wheel assist, it means that you have a switch to put it in four wheel drive mode. Okay, so I hope it is clear now. Now moving ahead, I will again explain the working principle of differential with the help of a layout. So this is basically the two-dimensional layout of a differential. So this is the pinion which we are talking about. So from this pinion is attached with gearbox. So in this side gearbox will be there. So from gearbox output is coming. Now this is a bevel gear. This smaller pinion is attached with this bigger crown gear. So power is coming here. From here power goes to here, bigger crown gear. Now this bigger crown gear is attached with this differential housing. Now they are here. In this case there are two differential housing. One is this section from here up to here, okay, and second one is this section. So this we call differential case LH or differential housing LH. This we call differential case RH or differential housing RH. Both LH side, left side and right side, is being attached together. It is being bolted together. Here there will be bolt, so both will act as a single unit because both are bolted together. Now as I have told you earlier also, this crown gear will be rigidly attached with this differential case. So this crown gear will be bolted. There will be bolt over here, okay. So this crown gear will be bolted with this differential housing. So whatever power is coming from here, power will go to this crown gear and same power will transfer to this differential housing. So if this is rotating and this differential gear is rotating, crown gear is rotating, and with this crown gear this differential housing is also rotating. Now this middle one, this shaft, this we call differential pin. On this pin there are two gears. One is this inside. Now this is inside differential, okay. This is the smaller differential pinion, and this is these two are side bevel gear, this one and this one is the side bevel gear. So in this view you are able to see one pinion and this is second pinion. Actually this is a four pinion differential, but in this view you will only able to see two pinions. Other two will be visible in a different view, okay. So these pinions are fitted on this pin, okay, and this pin is attached with this housing. You can see that there is a hole in this housing and this pin is passing through this hole, okay. So as I have told you, this differential housing will rotate about this axis, okay. So this is the axis, so this differential housing will rotate about this. It will simply revolve about this axis. Now this pin is passing through this differential housing, so this pin will also simply revolve about this axis. Now these pinions are fitted on this pin, so these pinions, this one pinion, two pinion and other two pinion also will revolve about this axis. So if your vehicle is going straight, then these two pinion will simply revolve about this axis. Just see my cursor, where my cursor is going. So these two pinion are revolving about this axis, but these pinions are not rotating about this axis, on its own axis. So this is the axis of this pinion. So this pinion is not rotating about this axis, it is simply revolving about this axis, okay. So in this case, now what will happen, this pinion is in mesh with this side bevel gear, so it will simply push this side bevel gear. So this side bevel gear and this side bevel gear, this will also rotate about this axis. So whenever vehicle is going straight, then whatever power is coming from here, power will come from here to this crown gear, from this crown gear to this housing, from this housing to pinion, from this pinion to side bevel gear. So in this case power will equally divide. Half of the power will go this side, half of the power will go this side. Now whenever your vehicle will start taking a turn, in that case these two pinions, it is still revolving about this axis, but at the same time it will also start rotating about this its own axis. And in that case both pinion will rotate on its own axis at different RPM, okay, depending upon the resistance which is being encountered by outer wheel and inner wheel, okay. So the one pinion will rotate at a faster speed, other pinion will rotate at a slower speed, and due to that these two side bevel gears will be able to achieve different RPM. So in that case this out, if it is taking a left turn, if vehicle is taking a left turn, in that case this will be inner bevel gear or inner tire, this will be outer, rotate at a faster speed, this inner will rotate at a slower speed, and due to that your tire will be able to take a turn, okay, easily. Now this is the output of this differential. This is the output of the differential. This I have named as sunshaft RH, and this I have named as sunshaft LH. So this is a gear over here, this gear. Now on this there will be planetary gear, and above that there will be ring gear. So basically this is the input to your final drive unit, which is in this case a planetary unit, and from that planetary unit there will be one rear axle which will be attached to tire, okay. So I hope that now its working principle is clear to you. If you still have, if you are not able to imagine how this is rotating on its own axis in case of turning, then I recommend you that there are a lot of animation which is available on YouTube, which you can simply see, in which you will be able to see how these pinions are rotating on its own axis when your vehicle is taking a turn. Okay, and then you then come back and then see this video, because I'm not using any animation over here. Okay, so again, whatever I have explained to you, input from gearbox is coming on the crown gear, this crown gear bolted with differential case LH. There are four pinions inside the differential unit. Two pinions are fitted on this longer differential pin, and other two will be fitted on a smaller differential pin, which is not shown in this layout. So other two is not visible in this view. Now the two side gears, these two side gears are mounted on sunshaft. Okay, this is a sunshaft, this is a sunshaft, which will finally act as output of differential, and this will be act as input to the final drive unit. Okay, so I hope that working principle of differential is clear to you now. Now we will see some of the formulas which are associated with differential and what is the law of differential. Okay, so the law of differential is that the two side bevel gear must always transmit equal torque. So as I have explained to you that this is one side bevel gear and this is other side bevel gear. So whenever vehicle is going in a straight direction, in that case, whatever power is coming from here will be equally divided in this side and this side. So now power is a combination of two things. One is torque and one is RPM. So what is getting divided? Whether RPM is getting divided or the torque is getting divided. So suppose if your input RPM at this crown wheel is 100 RPM, then your output will also be 100 RPM. So RPM will not getting divided in case of a straight run. So whenever your vehicle will go straight, whatever RPM is coming on differential housing or on this crown wheel, same RPM will be transferred to both LH and RH side. So if suppose your input on this gear is 10, okay, just for example, and the gear reduction between this pinion and this gear is 4, it means that RPM of this crown gear, it will be 10/4. Okay, now if it is 10/4, then the output of this sun and this sun, both LH and RH, will also be 10/4 and 10/4. So this is how RPM is getting divided. So RPM will be equal. Whatever RPM is coming on this crown gear, same will go to RH side and LH side. Okay. Now what about torque? Now whatever torque is coming on this, suppose torque is coming 100 Newton meter on this gear, then if direction is 4, then torque will be multiplied. So torque on this crown gear or on this housing will be 100 multiplied by 4. That is 400 Newton meter. Now, as I have told you that power is getting divided equally, half this side and half this side. Now, as I have also told you that RPM is not getting divided, RPM is same. It means that torque is getting divided. Okay, because power is the combination of RPM and torque. So if RPM is same, it means that torque is changing. So torque will also get divided equally. Half of the torque will go this side and half of the torque will go this side. So suppose if total torque coming on this housing or on this crown gear is 400 Newton meter, then 200 Newton meter will go in RH side and 200 Newton meter will go in LH side. So what is happening in differential? Power is getting divided equally, half half. Torque is getting divided equally, half half. And RPM will remain same. Now, if you see this figure, this N in is basically an input RPM. So I have given input RPM here also, and I have given input RPM here also. So there is one gear reduction over here. Then why I have given same input RPM is because whenever you will take power, I will always talk about power, and I always recommend you to solve differential numericals in terms of power. Okay. So what is happening is, if suppose n amount is coming over here, RPM, that RPM will get divided on this. So this will be n by gear reduction ratio. But torque will be multiplied. If torque is T on this, then torque on this crown gear will be T multiplied by whatever gear reduction. So whenever you will take power, then here in this case, RPM is more, torque is less. So power is some X amount. If you take power on this crown gear, then your RPM will be less and torque will be high. So power will ultimately be same. So whenever I'm talking about power, so whether you are taking input RPM on this crown gear or you are taking input RPM on this bevel pinion, it is not going to make any difference whatsoever because you are considering power, which is a combination of both torque and RPM. So if your RPM is high, your torque will reduce. If your torque is less, your RPM will be high. So your power will ultimately be same. That is why I have given that whether you take input on this crown gear or you take input on this bevel pinion, it is not going to make any difference. Okay. And then this NL is output of RPM in the left side and R is output in right side. So now the first thing is what we need to calculate in case of any differential is differential gear reduction. Now, whenever I am talking about differential gear reduction, it means that reduction which is happening over here. Okay, you might say that there are one more gear pair which is over here, and this is also seems like there is one reduction also happening over here. But just forget what is happening inside. Whenever I am talking about differential gear reduction, it means that reduction which is happening over here, that is number of teeth of this crown gear divided by number of teeth of this bevel pinion. And as you, if you have studied gears, then you might be knowing that number of teeth can be equivalent to diameter. So it will be diameter of a crown gear divided by diameter of a bevel pinion. So this I denoted by G. So G is equal to ZG by ZP. So ZG is number of teeth of this crown gear or simply gear. ZP is number of teeth of this bevel pinion. So the first thing which you always need to calculate in any differential numerical is differential gear reduction G. Now second thing is a speed relationship. There will be three relationship in case of differential: one speed relationship, one power relationship, and one torque relationship. So a speed relationship is what? You simply say C over here. So whatever N input is coming, now suppose in all case I am taking input in on this bevel pinion. Now this bevel pinion, if you take RPM on this crown gear, this will be divided by whatever reduction. So this N input divided by G, and as I have told you, that same RPM will be transferred in both left side and right side. So average will be what? NL plus NR by 2, and the same amount will be N in by G. Now if you see, as I have told you, if vehicle is going in a straight direction, NL will be equal to NR. So this 2-2 will get cancelled. So basically whatever RPM is coming on this divided by this gear reduction, same is going this side and same is going this side, which you can also prove by this equation. Now second relationship is power relationship. So as one gear pair is in mesh here, so there will be some power loss because of meshing efficiency or simply bevel gear efficiency. So this ED is simply efficiency. So whatever as you know that power conservation, the principle of conservation of power will always hold true in any case. So power, as you know, that power cannot be created, cannot be destroyed, it will always be conserved. So power output will be equal to power input, and there will be some efficiency of this gear, so that efficiency will be multiplied by input power. Now power output can be written as power going in left wheel, power going in right wheel. So that is what I have written here, PL plus PR. Now, as I have told you that power is a combination of torque and RPM, so simply P input, you can write it as T input and N input. Similarly, these two also you can write at TL NL plus TR NR equals to ED into T in N in. So this is the most important equation in case of a differential. This is what we call power relationship of differential. So TL NL plus TR NR is equal to ED multiplied by T in N in. I don't think that you need to remember this formula. If you have understood whatever I have explained to you till now, then you don't need to mug up this thing. You can simply just imagine this thing. Okay. So whatever input power is coming multiplied by differential efficiency will be equal to power in left wheel and power in right wheel. Okay. Now, third one will be torque relationship. So as I have told you, law of differential, that both bevel gears must always transmit equal torque. So torque in left wheel will be equal to torque in right wheel. And if both are equal, then simply with the help of this formula, you can simply take everything here. So ED into T in N in divided by NL plus NR. So So this will be your torque relationship. So these are the four formulas. One is G, one is this speed relationship, one is this power relationship, one is this torque relationship, which is important in case of a differential. Now I have told you that this law of differential is very important. And what this law of differential is saying, that no matter what is happening, if differential is acting, then torque in both the right and left wheel will always be same. Just remember this thing always. This is very important thing. Torque cannot be different in left side and right side if differential is working. Okay. This is very fundamental concept of the differential. RPM can be different as is happening in case of a turning. Your outer wheel RPM will be higher than your inner wheel RPM. And that is required to achieve a turning. So your RPM can be different, but the torque will always be same. So whatever torque is going in left side, same torque will go in the right side. Or whatever torque is going in right side, same torque will go in left side always, if differential is working. Okay. Now, moving ahead, this is the term which I have already explained to you. So all terms are written over here. I'm not going to explain it any further. Now, as I have told you, there will be in some cases there will be two pinions, and in some cases there will be four pinion. Why is it so, and what difference it is making? So in case of two pinion differential, this is a typical representative figure of a two pinion differential. It will looks like something like this. So this is your bigger crown gear, and this is your differential housing. Inside differential housing, you can see that this and this are two side bevel gears, and these two are two pinions which are attached on this differential pin. So this is a simple two pinion differential. Now, when we'll go about a four pinion differential, this is a typical representation of your differential housing, your four pinion differential housing. So if you see your two pinion housing and your four pinion housing, there is slight difference, that there is huge cutout over here. So as you don't need four pinions in this case, so you can simply remove the material and save the material. So this is a typical four pinion differential housing. Okay, both LH and RH is combined over here. Now, four pinion differential, how it looks like? It looks like something like this. So one pinion is here, second pinion is here, third pinion is here, and fourth pinion is just opposite 180 degree of this pinion in this side, which you cannot see in this view. And output will attached, one output will be this and one output will be from here. So this is a typical four pinion differential. If you open this up, then it will look like this. One pinion, second pinion, third pinion, fourth pinion, first side bevel gear, second side bevel gear. Okay, so this is a typical four pinion differential. It will look like this. If it is a car or a tractor or a truck, whatever it is, if it is a four pinion, it will look like this. If it is a two pinion, it will look like this. If it is a car, the size of gears will be less. If it is a truck or tractor, the size is more. Okay, now why two pinion is required? Why four pinion is required? So this is simply on the basis of torque. If you have two pinion, then torque will be shared, or load will be shared on between these two pinions. If you have four pinion, then the load will be shared by all four pinions. So if your torque, input torque, is very high, in that case you need four pinion. Okay, because load will be shared and your gear will be safe. If you have very less torque, then you can work with two pinion also. And if your torque is very high and you are using only two pinions, there might be a case when due to excess load your gear might break. So this is the only reason why we use two pinion, or sometimes we use four pinion. Okay, now second thing which I have told you, that whenever we talk about differential reduction, it means that we are talking about reduction between this bigger gear and pinion. We are not bothering about whatever reduction is happening inside between this pinion and this gear. Why is it so? Because whatever gear reduction you will put inside here and here, it is not going to make any difference in your RPM and torque. Then what is the function of this? So what is the function of this is, if you, as I have told you, that at the time of turning, your this side bevel gear and this side bevel gear will rotate at different speeds or at different RPMs. So what is happening if your vehicle is taking a left turn like this, then this is your outer gear, this is your inner gear. So this outer gear needs to rotate at a faster speed, and this inner gear needs to rotate at a slower speed. So suppose the condition, your vehicle is going in a straight. So the RPM of this both outer and inner, both LH and RH is same. Now suddenly you have a turn and you are taking a left turn. So your this gear needs to rotate at a faster speed, and this gear needs to rotate at a smaller, lower speed. And this speed difference needs to be achieved in a particular time, very less time. Okay, now here comes the role of this number of teeth. If the number of teeth of this pinion is very high, then whatever required speed difference you want to achieve, that can be achieved in a very less time. Okay, and if the number of teeth of this pinion is low, then it will take more time to achieve this same speed difference. At the same time, the other function is, if this number of teeth is very high or high, simply high, then the speed difference can be achieved smoothly, very smoothly. And if this number of teeth is less, then it will not achieve a speed difference very smoothly, but it will be a rough, there will be some noise or some cut kind of noise, and after that it will achieve that speed difference. So this is what this reduction between this pinion and this sidewheel gear is doing. Apart from that, it is not playing any role. So whether you put same number of teeth in both this and this, or different number of teeth, it is not going to make any difference, because you are not going to take any reduction over here. The role which I have explained to you, that is the only role these pinions are playing. So whenever, that is why I have told you, whenever we are talking about differential reduction, it means that reduction between this and the bevel pinion, because this is the only gear which is in mesh and which is transferring power. This inside gear is not transferring the power, it is simply transmitting the power. So there is a difference between transferring the power and transmitting the power. In case of transferring the power, you are multiplying your torque or RPM, but here that is not happening. It is simply transferring power to this side and to this side. Okay, so I hope that now the concept behind differential, or the theory behind differential, is clear to you. So this is the basic function of differential and basic principle of differential. And this is why differential is required in a vehicle, to allow your vehicle to turn efficiently. And how it is turning efficiently? Because it allows, differential allows your outer tire to rotate at a faster speed as compared to your inner tire. But because of this, there are certain disadvantages. So now we will see the disadvantages of differential, what is happening because of differential. Okay, so basically, as I have told you, a differential is needed for turning, but due to differential, it degrades the vehicle performance in two ways. Okay, now what is the disadvantage? First disadvantage is the torque in either side bevel gear is limited by the traction that can be developed by the attached wheel. Okay, I will explain it with this figure. Suppose your tractor is moving in a straight direction. So half of power will go, half power will go in this side, half power will go in this side. So this is clear to you now, I hope. And at the same time, whatever torque is coming from engine, half of the torque will go in left side, half of the torque will go in right side, in normal condition. Now suppose suddenly there is ice below one tire. Okay. So ice I have taken as an extreme example. When I am saying about ice, it can be mud also. So simply what I am trying to say over here is, now this surface is a poor traction surface, and now this tire is not able to generate traction. So simply what is happening, the torque on this tire, which is going on a poor traction surface, now torque on this tire is very less or zero. Okay, but this tire can generate sufficient amount of traction because it is on a concrete surface. So what will happen in this case, as I have told you, the law of differential. So law of differential is saying that whenever differential is in function, in that case, no matter what is happening, torque in both the wheels will always be same. Now in this case, what is happening? Torque on this left wheel is very less or near to zero. Okay. So now because of differential, torque on both the wheels would be same. So if torque on this is zero, then torque on this will also be zero. So this is what exactly is happening in case of mud. Whenever your tractor got stuck in the mud, in that case you might have observed that one wheel will simply not able to produce traction and this wheel will start slipping. And because torque is very less in this wheel, so same amount of torque is also coming on this wheel. Now this wheel can produce traction because this is on a good surface, but because torque is not coming on this wheel also, so your simply both wheel will start revolving on its own axis and your tractor will got stuck and it will not move forward. So this is the disadvantage of differential, that because of differential, this lower amount of torque which this tire is producing now, same torque, lower torque is transmitting to this wheel also, and because of that your tractor got stuck. And that is what I have written over here. The torque in either side gear is limited by the traction that can be developed by the attached wheel. So if one tire is generating very less traction or very less torque, then same will go to the other tire also. So for example, if one driving wheel is on seat of ice, which is a low traction surface, then virtually no torque can be developed in the corresponding side gear. And maximum torque which is transmitted through either axle is limited to the torque that can be supported by the wheel with the poorest traction. So this is a big disadvantage of differential. Due to differential only, your tractor at time will get stuck in the mud or on ice or on any poor traction surface. Okay, so this is the first disadvantage. Now second disadvantage is, as I have told you, that power is also equally divided, getting divided between this and this. And now this, because of poor traction, this will have very less torque. And at the same time, because torque is very less and resistance is very less, so RPM will become very high. And this wheel will start rotating at a very high speed. It is not moving forward, but it will simply revolve about this axis. In other terms, you can say that this wheel will start slipping at a very high speed. Okay. And as I have told you, that torque will be equal, so torque is zero on this wheel, torque is zero on this wheel, but very high RPM will go on this wheel, and this wheel RPM will be same as before or very less RPM. So what is happening now? As I have told you, power is a combination of torque and RPM, so torque is same in both the wheel, but RPM of this wheel is very high, so more power is coming to this wheel as compared to this wheel. So what is written over here. In dividing the input power between the two axle, the differential transmits most of the power to the axle with poorest traction. So most of the power is going to this wheel, not to this wheel. This wheel can take you out of this ice surface, or this wheel can simply help you to move your tractor in forward direction. But because of differential, what is happening is most of the power is coming to this wheel, and that power is simply getting wasted into tire slip. And power is not coming to this wheel, which can move the tractor in forward direction. And since the torque is equal in both the axle, the power divides in accordance with axle speed. So this axle speed is higher, so power is higher in this case. So this is what is happening because of differential. So if differential will not be there, then what will happen? This tire will help the tractor to get out of this condition, or your tractor will not get stuck in the mud or in the ice. But because differential is there, so what differential is doing? Due to poor traction, this torque is very less, and the same amount of torque will come on this wheel also. And most of the power will come on this wheel, not on this wheel. So these two are the disadvantage of differential. So because of differential, your tractor will get stuck in the mud or in the poor traction surface, and it will not be able to come out of that condition. Then what will you do? How can you overcome this disadvantage? So there are two ways to overcome this disadvantage. One is to put differential lock. So as I have explained to you, your crown gear is being bolted with differential housing, and from differential housing power will go to. Now in case of differential lock, what it is doing is, you will have I will explain it with the help of a figure. So as you can see over here, this is the figure of differential lock. So there will be one coupler over here, and there will be one lever. I hope that you are aware about differential lock lever. So now suppose if your vehicle got stuck in the mud or in the poor traction surface, so then you will simply slide this fork in this direction. So this pin will go and sit inside. There will be holes inside this side bevel gear. So this pin will go and it will sit on those holes. So now what is happening? This coupler, this side bevel gear, and this housing, both will act as a single unit. So now whatever torque is coming on this is bolted with the housing. So same torque will go to this housing also. And now you have fitted this pins with this housing and this side bevel gear, so everything is locked now. So this everything will behave as a single unit. So now if differential is locked, so now differential is not working. So basically whatever was happening inside, this pinion was rotating on its own axis, so that is not happening now. Okay, so now what is happening is your torque, as I've told you earlier, the law of differential, the torque in both LH and RH will always be same. That thing will not happen now. So now what will happen in case of differential lock? Your torque can be different in both LH and RH. So the wheel which can produce higher traction, more torque will go in that side, and the wheel which is producing less traction, less torque will go in that side. And now your RPM will be same, because you have locked everything, so your RPM can no longer be different. So in this case, RPM of both LH and RH will be same. So now imagine the same condition, the first condition. So your RH wheel is on a good traction surface. It can generate more amount of torque. So more torque is coming here, and RPM, same RPM is coming in both the side. So now torque is also here, sufficient amount of torque and sufficient amount of RPM. It means that now the wheel which can produce more traction, the RH wheel, more power is coming to this wheel. So now your tractor will simply come out of that stuck condition or from mud. It will come out of mud very easily. But one precaution which you need to take is you should not take any turn in case of differential lock condition. Why is it so? Because as I have explained to you, that at the time of turning, these two pinions are start rotating on its own axis, this axis. Now you have simply locked everything, so you are simply not allowing the differential speed. You are not simply allowing these pinions to rotate on different speeds on its own axis. But if we will take a turn, so you are forcing these pinions to rotate on its own axis. So either your lock will break, or your gears will break, or your steering gear will break. Something will break. Okay, so that is why companies are not recommending to take a turn when differential is in locked condition. So when differential is locked, at that time differential is simply not working. So whenever differential will work, whenever differential is in action, at that time torque will be same. But whenever differential lock is applied, at that time torque can be different, but RPM will be same. Just remember these two things always. So this is the one mechanism, differential lock mechanism, which is a very simple mechanism to overcome this disadvantage. The second concept is limited slip differential. Okay, this is kind of automatic differential lock. Now, as I have told you earlier, that why differential is required? Differential is required because different amount of turning is RPM is required at the time of turning. So what limited slip differential is doing, it will allow a simple speed differences between two axle, which is required at the time of vehicle turning. But whenever the speed difference exceed a certain limit, then it will work on a principle of centrifugal force. So suppose the condition of ice, so this wheel is rotating at a very faster RPM and this wheel is rotating at a very low RPM. So very huge amount of centrifugal force, as you know that centrifugal force is what? mv square by r. So if v is I, a very high, then the centrifugal force will be very high. So in that ice example, this wheel centrifugal force is very high. So this is a centrifugal force operating spring. So this will simply expand due to that centrifugal force. And when this will expand, this will simply push this bevel gear. When it will push this bevel gear, there are clutches which are fitted inside this. So these clutches will get engaged. And whatever thing is this differential lock is doing, this clutch will do same thing. It will lock the differential and your vehicle will come out of that position. So you can see a lot of things are available about limited slip differential on YouTube. You can see those videos. I am not going to explain more detailed explanation of this limited slip differential. If you want me to explain this, just put it in comment section. I will make a separate video, because this is out of context in this thing. Okay, so these are the two ways. One is simple differential lock, and second is limited slip differential, by which you can overcome the disadvantages of differential. So guys, this is what I need to teach you about differential. So I have covered all theoretical aspect of differential. I hope that you have understood the principle behind the differential, how it is working, what is the difference between an automotive differential and a car differential and a truck differential and a tractor differential. What is the working mechanism of differential? What is the principle or what is the law of a differential? How torque is getting divided? How RPM is getting divided? How power is getting divided? I have given you some formulas. I hope that you have just noted it down, all those formulas in your notebook, and you have understood the concept behind differential. Now, we will move further and we will just solve a conceptual problem for your better clarity. And whatever we have explained till now, you will be able to see it more clearly once I will explain that numerical to you. So the first problem, the conceptual problem. So the problem says that for a differential, assume that number of teeth of a bevel pin is 20, number of teeth of bevel gear is 60, bevel pinion turns at 550 RPM, and the torque of pinion is 2800 Newton meter. Now differential efficiency, they have given 90%. Now there are three problems over here. The first one is saying that vehicle is traveling in a straight direction on a uniform surface, and you have to calculate a speed, torque and power at each side gear. In second case, your one wheel, the left wheel, is encountering a poor traction surface, so your torque transmitting ability will drop by 10%, and at the same time it will start rotating 30% faster than the wheel driven by right side gear. So just try to now remember whatever I have explained to you earlier in case of that ICE example, that your torque transmitting ability is getting dropped, at the same time RPM will increase. Okay, so in this case again it is saying you to calculate a speed, torque and power at each side bevel gear. And the third question is, how many kilowatt does the power in left axle exceeds that in right axle, and what is the fate of the power difference? Okay, so we will solve each of these one by one. So the first thing is, vehicle is going straight on a uniform surface. So there are some inputs which is being given. Number of teeth of pinion is 20, number of teeth of gear is 60. Now RPM, input RPM is given 550, input torque is given 2800, and transmission efficiency is given 96% in the problem. Okay, so now the first thing which I have told you is gear reduction, G, simply ZG by ZP. I think that it is clear to you now. So it is 3 in this case. So first thing always which you need to calculate is gear reduction. Now second thing, a speed relationship. So this is the equation which I have told to you in case of a speed relationship. You have values of each and everything, you just need to put the values. So basically NL plus NR will be 2NI by G. Now you already know NI, which is 550. So simply NL plus NR will be, from here you can calculate NL and NR. Now in this case, as I told you, the vehicle is going straight. So if vehicle is going straight, then you know that both RPM of left wheel and right wheel will be same. So you can calculate NL and NR simply, and it will be 183.3. Simply you just put 550 over here, and NL and NR both are same. So this is the value of NL and NR. Now second thing which I have told you is power relationship. So this is what I have equation I have told you about power relationship. Now you know that if vehicle is going straight, then torque will be always be same. Okay, so if differential is acting, so law of differential says that torque will always be same. So TL will be equal to TR. So now this is straightforward. So from here you can calculate simply TL, and same thing will be TR. Okay, moving ahead. So now you know the value of torque, now you know the value of RPM in both LH side and RH side. So you can calculate power now. So power input, you know input torque, you know input RPM. Power is simply 2 pi NT by 60. So with the help of input RPM and input torque, you know this is, this will be the input power in watt. And considering 96% efficiency, your P input will be 0.96 multiplied by this. So finally, your input power is 15,154,739.2 watt. Okay. Now, output power. So you know the torque in left side, you know the RPM in left side, and your vehicle is going straight. So power in both left side and right side will be same. And you know the value of RPM and torque, so you can calculate simply PL and PR like this. Now, you, if you just add up PL and PR, you will find that it will be equal to your input power. Okay, so your input power is this much, and the summation of PL and plus P plus PR is this much. So as you can see that whatever I explained to you, the rule of conservation of power, it is being hold true over here. So input power is getting equally divided between left wheel and right wheel, and input power will be is equal to output power. So the rule of conservation of power is being adhered over here. Now moving to second question. Left wheel on a poor traction surface. So what is happening? Torque is getting reduced by 10% and RPM is 30% faster with respect to RPM of right wheel. Okay, so again, SP relationship, NL plus NR is equal to 2NI by G. Now you know that NL is equal to 30% higher than NR, so 1.3 times of NR. Simply just put the, these values and you will find out that NR will be 159.4 and NL will be 1.3 times higher, so 207. Okay. Now what about torque? So torque is getting reduced by 10%, so it will be, new torque will be this much, reduced by 10%, but still differential is working, so torque will be same. So whatever less torque is going in left side, same torque will go in right side also. So TL will be equal to TR, will be equal to this much. So now again, you know torque at each and every point, RPM at each and every point, so you can calculate power again. So PL will be this much, PR will be this much. Okay, when you add up these two things, you will get this value. This much is the output power. Now, so again, now we have a torque, RPM and power at each and every point. So again, coming to the question, the first question, you see when vehicle is going straight, you have same RPM on both LH and RH side, you have same torque on both LH and RH side, you have same power in both LH and RH side, and when you add up the PL and PR, it will be equal to your input power. So the rule of conservation of power is being adhered in this case when vehicle is going straight. Now second question, when vehicle is encountering a poor traction, in that case, as you have already calculated, NR is less, NL is high, so by 30%, so this much is NL, this much is NR. Now torque, it's same in both the cases, both TR and TL. Now when you are calculating power, your PL is higher, your PR is less. So as I have explained to you in case of that ICE example, that left wheel, the wheel which is encountering lower traction, more power will go to that wheel. So you can see over here, this left wheel is encountering poor traction, but it is rotating at a faster speed. Torque is same in both the case, and that torque is lower torque, and more power is going to the left wheel, less power is going to the right wheel, and this is the reason why your tractor got stuck, and this is the disadvantage of differential, which you can see now clearly in this example. So your PL plus PR is this much, but you can say that output power here is not equal to input power. Okay, so you can, you might have this doubt that rule of conservation of power is not adhered in this case, but that is not true. Now what is happening in this case, your tractor is simply got stuck, your tractor is not able to pull your implement or whatever it is behind, your tires are simply revolving or simply slipping. So in this case, torque requirement now is less as compared to the previous example when it was pulling some implements or a trolley. So what is happening, this is the basic nature of engine. If your power requirement is less, then your engine is not going to produce more power. Suppose, as for example, you have a 50 HP tractor and you need only 10 HP to pull your implement, then your engine, even it is able to produce 50 HP, it will not produce 50 HP. It will only produce 10 HP, which is required to pull your implement. Same thing is happening in this case. So in this case, if your output is this much, your input will also be equal to this much only, but you are not able to calculate that because you don't have those measurements. So in this case also, if you measure the input power, that will be equal to this only. And this is reduced. Why this is reduced? Because now your torque is getting reduced and your RPM is not that much high. So your power requirement is less. So if your power requirement is less, so your engine is going to produce less power only. Okay. And what is the third question is, what it is asking? How many kilowatt the power left axle exceed? So simply this 78,000 minus this 60,000. So simply 18,000. Okay. So power in left wheel is more and power in right wheel is less. And what is happening with that left wheel power? This power is simply getting wasted in wheel slippage. So what is the fate of this power difference? The fate is that power is simply getting wasted. And why it is happening is because this is the disadvantage of differential. Due to differential, same lower torque will go to both left side and right side. More RPM will go to the wheel, which is encountering poor traction, and power will simply get wasted. So this was this is a very good example to see what is happening in this differential. And if you are able to solve this numerical, and if you have understood this numerical, then all concept related to differential should be clear to you. And I hope that I am able to explain these things in simple terms to you. And if you have understood this, then I hope that everything about differential is now clear to you. Okay, so this was a very good conceptual problem on differential. Now moving ahead, we will solve a gate problem. This was asked in gate 2016, 46 number problem. And this is a controversial problem because answer is not matching. Okay, official answer in this case is not matching. So we will see. The question is saying a tractor rear axle differential bevel pinion has 12 teeth, crown gear has 42 teeth, input speed and torque of pinion is 520 and 1200 respectively. And there is a planetary gear between differential unit and each half axle. As I have already told you, the output of differential will go to a final drive unit. So this planetary gear is simply a final drive unit with 4:1 speed reduction. Now left wheel encounters poor traction when the tractor is moving in a straight path. It causes 15% drop in left axle torque. Okay, it is, the question is saying only about torque. There is no nothing has been given about RPM. Okay, and the differential efficiency is 0.98. So it is asking you the right axle torque under the locked differential condition. Okay, so differential is, when differential is locked, at that time differential is not working simply. And it is asking what will be the torque on right axle when differential is locked. So it is a very straightforward question. If you have understood my previous problem and whatever I have explained to you about differential, then you will definitely be able to solve this problem. Okay. Now this problem is very simple, which we can solve in just one line, but for the sake of your understanding, I will explain it in detail. We will take different condition again. So the first condition is, these are the data givens which you know. So the first condition can be tractor is going straight on a good traction surface. So what will happen in this case, as this will be the differential reduction. I hope that you are able to understand whatever I am saying. This will be 3.5. Now speed relationship, you already know. So you are able to calculate this RPM, NR plus NL will be equal to this. From here you can calculate NR and NL different. So even tractor is going straight, the speed will be same. Now final reduction is given 4:1. So if you want to calculate this on wheel, then you have to simply divide this RPM by 4. So 37 will be the wheel RPM. Okay, now moving ahead, power relationship, same thing as I have already explained to you in first numerical. Okay, so easily you can calculate torque on both the wheels, RPM on both the wheels, and when you will calculate on wheel, then you have to accommodate this final reduction. So torque will be multiplied by 4, RPM will be divided by 4. So your torque will be 8232 newton meter on wheel, RPM will be this much. So your power will be this much. considering 98% differential efficiency. So 64,000 watt will be your input power, and output power will be 32,000 watt. So PR and PL, when you will add this 32,000.4, you are getting this input power. So as you can see that the conservation of power is getting adhered over here. Okay. Now, second condition, suppose one surface has poor traction. So your question has given that torque is getting reduced by 15%. So new torque will be 0.85 of your old torque. So your old torque was 8232. So your new torque will be 85% of this. So new torque is 6997.2 Newton meter. And right now I am not considering differential lock condition. I am simply assuming in this condition that one surface has poor traction, but still differential is working. So if differential is working, then torque will be same in both right and left wheel. Okay. Now comes the tricky part in this question. Now some people can assume that if torque is reducing by 15%, then RPM will increase by 15%. But guys, this is not given in the question. Question is not talking about RPM. There is no data has been given about RPM. What is the fate of RPM? So you cannot simply assume that if torque is reducing by 15%, then RPM will increase by 15%. This will not be the right approach. As you might have seen in the first numerical, in that case torque was reducing by 10% and RPM was increasing by 30%. Okay, so this is not true. So if you are considering that your RPM is increasing by 15%, then you are going in a wrong direction. But even if you are considering this 15%, then this will be your NL, this will be your NR. NR will be same, NL will reduce by 15%. It will increase by 15%, so NL will become 42. And same thing, input power is this much and output power will be this much. So if you are going by this way, considering this, then you can see that simply this addition is not equal to this much, because as I have explained to you earlier, now one surface is encountering poor traction, so power requirement is less, so input power will also simply reduce. So this is a wrong method. This is a wrong method. You don't know anything about RPM. So you should not consider that RPM will also increase by 15%. This is conceptually wrong. Okay. So that is why you cannot solve this thing. Now moving ahead, the third condition question has given that it is a lock differential. Okay. This is actually the solution of this problem. So in case differential will be locked, then as I have told you earlier that RPM will be same now and torque can be different now, because now differential is no longer working. It is getting locked. Okay. So now what will happen? Question has told you that torque is reduced by 15%. So this is by 10%. So this is your new torque and question is not saying anything about RPM. So you have to take same RPM, but anyway, this RPM will not come in picture because it will get canceled out. So you can simply put the value of TL in this equation, value of NR and NL in this equation. You know the input torque, you know the input RPM, you know transmission efficiency. So you can simply calculate TR from here, and that TR will be equal to how much? TR will be equal to this much, and finally you will get TR 2366.7 Newton meter. But they have given a final reduction ratio also 4, so you have to multiply this TR by 4 to get torque at the wheel. So when you multiply it by 4, you will get 9466.95 Newton meter. So guys, this will be your final answer. Now in this case, I have taken this RPM also in picture. So I have told you to put this RPM and this torque in this equation to find out this TR, but you can simply solve this problem in one line. How? I have explained to you the three relationship. I hope that you remember that. One was speed relationship, second one was power relationship, and third was torque relationship. So if you know that torque relationship, you can simply don't need any data of RPM. Simply you just need to put the value of torque there and you will find TR. Okay, considering transmission efficiency. So actually this is the correct way of solving this problem. Or if you remember that my concept when I have explained to you about different equations, Just hold for a minute. I will go to that slide and I will show to you that equation. See, this is the equation. So TR will simply be equal to transmission efficiency multiplied by input torque multiplied by input RPM divided by NL plus NR. So simply by this one equation you can solve this thing. But I personally recommend you to not use this torque equation. Simply use this power relationship always, because this is more handy and you will have more clear-cut picture of each and everything in this case. Okay, so I hope that these two problems are clear to you now. Now, next thing what I am going to explain to you, that as I have told you the wrong approach to solve this problem. You see the official answer of this problem. In my case, the answer is coming 9466.9 Newton meter. But if you see official answer, that is less than this. So I hope that that answer is wrong. Whoever have solved that problem, that answer is wrong. But I have seen one snapshot. Somebody has sent me one snapshot. But before going to that snapshot, I will show you again how the power conservation rule is adhered in this case. So in this case, I have calculated torque. This much amount of torque is coming on right wheel. Okay, and on left wheel, you already know this is the torque on left wheel. So now if you calculate power, you know the torque on right wheel, you know the torque on left wheel, you know the RPM on both the wheels. So RPM is same in locked condition and torque is different in locked condition. So whatever I have taught you, you can see the answer over here. So if you calculate power, so PR will be this much, PL will be this much, and if you add up these two things, you will get this much amount of power, 64,000 watt. Now remember the input power, input whatever we have calculated initially, input power is also same, 64,000. So and I have already considered transmission efficiency while calculating TR, so you don't need to consider it again. So as you can see, that rule of conservation of power is again being adhered over here. Okay, so I think this is the right approach to solve this problem. Now when somebody has sent me this snapshot, this is the solution, numerical solving book. In that they have solved this problem and they have given this answer, which is which they have matched with official answer key of gate. Now there are two three things which is wrong in this approach. This when they are started calculating, everything is same initially. So without differential, this is correct. Up to here it is correct. Torque on each axle is 8400 Newton meter. We have also seen this thing is coming. So this thing is correct. Now whatever I have told you, that second case, condition in which left axle has 15% torque drop. So the question is saying that torque is getting dropped by 15%, but question is not saying anything about RPM. But they have simply assumed that speed is getting increased by 15% and they have multiplied this 37 by 1.15. so this consideration itself is wrong, because question has not talked about speed. And as you have seen in my previous example, that if torque is getting dropped by 10%, RPM is getting increased by 30%. So if torque is getting dropped by 15%, then with same logic, RPM should be increased by around 40-45% or even 50%. So this consideration, until and unless, guys, it is being mentioned in the question that a speed is also getting changed by this much percent, don't consider this thing, because this is conceptually wrong. Okay, so by considering this, if you calculate, you will be able to answer the question and this will be getting matched with official answer key, because somebody who have solved that gate problem in IIT, they might also has done same wrong assumption. They might have taken this same wrong assumption and then they might have solved this problem, but this is conceptually wrong. Okay, so that is why I believe that this answer is wrong and the previous answer is correct. Okay, if you feel otherwise and if you feel something doubt in my previous approach, you can ask me in the comment section what is your point of view on this. Okay, so this was all about differential. So I hope that now each and everything about differential, all your doubts are clear now. So thank you very much for watching, guys. And one more thing, we have achieved the my first milestone of 1,000 subscriber. Our channel has crossed 1,000 subscriber limit. So thank you very much for that. And please again spread the word in your peer groups in universities that there is a platform on which you can rely completely for your doubts, for your queries, and for your conceptual clarity. So if you like this video, please like it, subscribe the channel, and comment on in the comment section if you have any doubt. So thank you very much guys again for watching it, and happy new year to all of you. I hope that in this new year you will achieve great success in your preparation and in your life also. So again, thank you very much for watching.